So how do you diagnostically prioritize if you have somebody who has multiple comorbidities? They have binge drinking, they have bipolar disorder, they have OCD and ADHD. How many people here see ADHD patients that are straightforward, monodiagnostic, and easy to treat? Show of hands. I don't think I see a single hand up in the audience. That's right. And so when researchers talk about ADHD, please understand that they're talking about clinical trials that have sanitized the population. You can't get into the trial unless all you have is ADHD, which is why clinicians will always say that the research population is not the population of patients I see. Second order effect, if you realize that then, if you see prevalent rates in general population, that is not the prevalence rates in your clinical practice. The clinical practice prevalence rates are 2 to 3 times higher. Why? Because they're coming in because they have psychological issues. And so keep all of this in mind because it makes you a sharper clinician to understand these things conceptually first and then dial down. So I wrote this almost 20 years ago. And you look at this prioritization, it's alcohol and substance abuse first, and severe mood disorder second, severe anxiety disorders third, and then ADHD last. And you would say, well, Dr. Goodman, did you publish it in the Journal of Duh? And it's reasonable to say that because you now all accept this as kind of a bit of a common sense. And why is it set up this way? Why did I set it up this way 20 years ago? Because the cognitive and emotional issues you see in ADHD, you can see in all the aforementioned other diagnoses. And the medications that you would choose for ADHD may make the aforementioned untreated disorders worse.